tire of maintaining homeostasis. I will relieve you of your burden.
You offend this one, Thera. What ladybug do about it? Exterminate.
Yes, well, good afternoon again, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Pain Gaming. And today, I just thought I'd go to do a bit more in-depth look at some of the games that I saw at E3 during last week's conferences and all. And also, we want to look at the main one, really, what we're all here for mainly is Mortal Kombat X. So basically, what I'm going to do is I'm going to talk about a few things. Okay, basically a quick rundown of what I thought altogether at E3. Conferences were good. Sony, again, I think came out with the strongest conference again this year. Nintendo was definitely up there as well. Microsoft was good, but I feel that it just had, like, again, it just had really games to show off. I mean, I know practically they all sort of had games, but Nintendo had stuff like the Super Smash Bros. Characters that they're going to be bringing out for their the games, and Sony mentioned the Project Morpheus, but didn't really show it, which was a shame because I kind of wish they did. They did show it off, but what can you do? But again, I feel that Sony and PlayStation looks like it's got a lot more better games coming out for it. But like again, they're showing off these particular games, but they're obviously a lot of them are coming out for both consoles. So you know, it's stuff like that, really. You know. I'd have to say the games that I'm looking forward to name a few now, probably don't have all of them in my head, but to name a few, I'm looking forward to The Crew, looks interesting. I'm looking forward to Shadow of Mordor, looks brilliant. Definitely Assassin's Creed Unity. What else am I looking forward to? The Order looks interesting, but it just looks like a knockoff of Resident Evil, really. well, it remains to be seen. What else are we looking forward to? We're looking forward to. I'd like to give Super Smash Bros. A try, but I don't have the Wii U yet, so. Well, I have a 3DS, I might get it for 3DS. Mortal Kombat X, obviously. And to name one more, Battlefield Hardline looks interesting, but I don't know if Cops and Robbers sort of thing, it's not purely Battlefield anymore. They shouldn't really call it Battlefield, so you just call it a Hardliner. It's just Hardline or something really like that, you know. Anyway, right, to give my quick rundown view of MK at E3. We'll just go through. We'll just go through some. What we're gonna do now is we're gonna go through some of the matches that we saw from GameSpot during their interview. We're gonna throw up each different matches, and we'll look at the match, and we'll talk. I'll talk during the match to give you like what I think of each person's moves and the fatalities at the end, and then of course, you know, just the things in general. So let me pull these up here. Okay, so the first one we're gonna look at is Cassie Cage versus Freya. Anyway, so the first one we're going to look at really is Cassie Cage versus Farrah and Tor. Okay, so let's watch that. It's weird the way the intros don't have sound, but I'd imagine they're just trying to keep the sound for a while. So I think in this one, Cassie Cage is using her Spec Ops variation. I think Farrah Tor. Yeah, actually, sorry, you can see it at the top there.
Drop table. Clear high.
So Cassie Cage has Spec Ops, she basically can call in missiles and stuff to attack the player. Or her opponent, should I say. And then Guerrera, Sora, and Vicious. Guerrera can, I think it's in Vicious, Guerrera can stab the back of Tor, which puts him into an enrage mode. And then he basically just goes, he deals damage, but he also takes damage again. So it's like it's a win-lose sort of situation, really. And that's it for that match. He doesn't really have the cocky attitude of Cage, you see. Okay, the next one we're going to look at is, Cassie Cage again. This time she's going to be against Kotal Kahn, which is another one of the new characters in Mortal Kombat. Again, I'll be giving my brief overview of these and stuff after the battles themselves. Like, during which I'll just, you know, give them my impressions and stuff. So again, she comes out. As you can see, her hands are glowing this time. So she's in a different variation than what she was in. This time she is in Brawler. So I think it's much more hands-on, melee attacks and stuff. And Kotal Kahn right now is in the War God mode, which... as you can see on the back there, he's got his giant sword, so it gives him a bit more reach, and of course sword weapon attacks, really. As you can see actually as well, the second name of Cassie is Cage. It's Johnny Cage and Sonya's daughter. They got together. As for Kotal Kahn, there is there's rumors going around right now, speculation really, that it's something to do with Chow Kahn. It could be his brother, it could be his son. They don't know really, you know. Could be even his father, you know, something like that. But right now, Kotal Kahn is some sort of god, because each of its variations is a war god, blood god, and sun god. So TMK actually pointed out that it might even be an Outworld god, if you get me. So you never know with these sort of things. There's his X-ray move, it was very brutal. Low blows, classic Cage. That throw is weird. I don't know what he's doing to her. Forcing her with energy or something, really, you know? Which is funny, actually. The way Sonya, and it's Sonya and Johnny Cage's daughter, she's using guns. Like, neither of those two characters really use guns in the old Mortal Kombat, but she's kind of taking a heat from Striker, I'd imagine. Finish him here. I think we're gonna see a fatality. Yeah, there's Cassie Cage's fatality. That's good. Good fatality there. Right, so the next one we're going to go on to is Devora and Ferritor as well for this one. So let's watch this one, shall we? I think these two both fight on the cove. Yeah. So we saw the snow forest there with the last two battles. This one now is... no, not the cove, what am I saying? Sorry. The Outworld Market. I'll give this a brief thing as well. Like, in the Outworld market, it doesn't feel very Outworld, if you get me, you know? Outworld was all, it's all, it's, it looks too summery there, you know? Outworld's meant to be very dark, full of death, I mean, full of, like, torture, and just in total sort of chaos, chaos not really. I mean, I wouldn't consider Outworld to have a marketplace, if you get me, you know, that sort of way. I mean, if it was, if they were a marketplace, it would probably be inside the walls of Shao Kahn's castle or something, or even just drifters going around, you know, but it's just, it looks weird. I mean, I do hope they, like, make it a bit more darker. So in this one, Ferrer Torres is in the lackey, so as you can see, Farrah is in the background. She's just kind of egging him on, you know, she's cheering him on and stuff like that, and Thor is on his own, which basically allows for a lot more grapple moves and stuff, and Devorah is in her Swarm Queen mode, which allows her to summon the flies and stuff, and those... The things that she has there, I think, yeah, here's her actually move now, actually. This is very, very rude. That's brilliant. You think a stab to the back of the head would kill some? The end of Ferritor. I'm very interested to see the new character's story and how they play into the whole Mortal Kombat lore, you know? Okay, the next one is Kotal Kahn versus Sub-Zero. I think it's back in the numbers. No, sorry, this one's on the go. Sub-Zero's in his Cryomancer form, so he allows him to, he's got, like, allows him to use, like, an ice sword and an ice hammer in a lot of his moves. And Kotal Kahn is in Blood God mode, which allows him to use these types of, urns, like, that come up, or that he summons, basically, allows him to give him the powers and stuff. He can also use a Beam of Light that'll heal him, but hurt his opponent. Certain power while that's up, like it is. I will freeze your you probably see another fatality here. Yeah. Calls Conlon, he rips him open. Pulls out the heart. Classic MK style and drinks the blood. Alright. Now, where are we at? I think what we'll do is we'll just skip to the last there. I have like three other fights, but what I'll do is they're on my main channel anyway. If you want to, they're on this channel here. Sorry, if you want to look at them. One of them is Scorpion versus Ferrator, and then the other one is Sub-Zero versus the Devora. But there is one there with Sub-Zero versus Scorpion, so we're gonna watch that now. And just to crack it, having to end it with another Sub-Zero versus Scorpion. And of course, all the Sub-Zero ones will probably love this one because. I like the intros, I must say. The intros, the way they talk to each other and all is very good. So in this one, Sub-Zero's in Grandmaster stance. He's got the amulet on him. And he does all sorts of, he's got all more sort of like ice combos and stuff. Scorpion's in Inferno mode, which allows him to summon a demon from the Netherrealm to help him out. You probably see him now. I think he can either dive kick from the top, punch Sub-Zero from the bottom, or holds Sub-Zero from the top. So we'll end it now on Sub-Zero's fatality. Very nice. It's always cringeworthy stuff, right? Alright, well that was some of the fights that we saw at E3. while watching the match anyway. So I just want to give my views on a lot of the stuff that I see and then give my speculation then to later, to what I think and hope is going to happen. So let's say the characters that we saw, Scorpion and Sub-Zero, they're back, they're even more badass than ever. The looks on them now, they look pretty good. Again, like I said from the original trailer, I didn't like the way Sub-Zero looked without his mask, but that was obviously because of a CGI trailer, so... I mean, in there he looks pretty good. The eyes look a bit weird though, but you know, that's probably just me. So the variations are an interesting way of what Ed's doing to the series. It'd be an interesting way to see which variation will do against another character's variation, if you get me. So it'd be interesting to see that. And the arenas, from what we saw, I like the look of the cove. The cove looks alright. The forest is proper dark, proper the way it's meant to be. You know, you're able to grab the branches and wallop people in the head and stuff like that. The Outworld market, it just doesn't feel like Outworld to me. Like, Outworld's meant to be this dark, gritty death all over the place. You know, people wouldn't as much as look at you then, you know, try and kill you, basically, you know. So, I really do hope they kind of change it up a bit. Maybe darken it a bit, put in a bit more, like, death and destruction maybe going on in the background. I mean, there is a torture device in the background, you know, which was interesting. And there is a castle in the background. Might be Shao Kahn's castle, but we don't know. But, like, it doesn't seem like a place where a market's just going to open up, you know. But then again, that's just me. I'm just speculating again, really. The overall look of the game. Okay. The look of the game, again, like I'm kind of saying, like, I like the look of it a bit. But not all over, like, look. Cove and the forest look good. Again, Outworld market doesn't look very outworldy. I'm sure the character select screen really is going to change because It was just, I think, I honestly think this version was just thrown together for E3 to give the fans something. I honestly do not think that this is the final version, but I just hope the Outworld market isn't really done and dusted and swept to the side arena. I hope they have a look at that a bit more. The feel of it, really, the feel of it, it feels like MK, but it also feels like Injustice. But I just, you know, an MK game has to be all MK. I mean, fair enough, they can throw in some of the Injustice things, like being able to take stuff in from the background and bringing it to the foreground and using it as a projectile or something against your enemy. That's a good, that was brilliant in Injustice. I like that so much. But to have, like, a lot of the characters, like, the Farah and Thor, the Thor model, who's modeled after, they were saying it on the, live chat, Bane. From Injustice, you know, and it just, it does feel kind of lazy that if they're going to take one character model and just mask it and throw it into this game. But then again, like I said, I feel that this was just thrown together for E3. I don't think it's the end, really, you know. Fatalities are back. Fatalities are more brutal than ever, but there was one fatality that they never showed with Scorpions, which was meant to be very brutal. As in, we saw a bit of it during the Fatality trailer. He gets a ball of fire, shoots it through his chest, the heart comes down. You can see, like, the blood gnawing the heart and stuff like that. He falls to his knees, and then Scorpion gets the sword and hits him, but, like, they'll cut it there. Now, what I've heard from other people, that the second part of the Fatality is Scorpion cuts off the face, and then the face falls off. The bits of brain and stuff start coming out through the eye sockets, and the tongue is twitching. That's what I've heard. I don't know if that's a thing, but if it is, I like it. It's Mortal Kombat, but I feel it's going a bit too far in regards to, like, you know, I'm not complaining that it's like I love the fatalities and stuff like that, but I never thought I'd see something that brutal in a Mortal Kombat game, you know. Then again, you know, it's Ed Boon. It's just taking it to the next level, you know. Okay, that's more or less what I thought about the E3 demo. I do hope the demo itself gets released to us maybe at a later stage, like what they did with MK9 when that was in E3. We got the demo, and I think you were able to choose between Scorpion, Sub-Zero, Melina, and Johnny Cage, was it? I think it was those four characters. Maybe it was just three. I don't know, we'll have to see anyway. So hopefully, now just to give my speculation and some of my views on other things. Now, this has come up time and time again, and I know everyone agrees and everyone, the font. Okay, yeah, the font. If you, like, you've seen during the fights I showed you there a second ago. The round one and round two, the fight, the finisher, and even, like, you know, wins, the win, even their names, really, you know. I mean, I honestly don't like that font. It's just like, you know, it feels, again, just, it's not, because, like, when you had finishing in any of the other Mortal Kombat, it came up from the background, just goes, finish him, you know, or, and this one is just kind of lazily transitions, saying just finish him, and then the eye kind of, like, drops down to the bottom. I don't like that, really. I'm not a big fan of it, but like I said again, from previous things, I honestly think this was just thrown together for E3. I don't think this is going to be the final font. I think they just wanted to make it look a bit classy in E3. Well, I hope it's not the final font. Especially the hood. The hood looks horrible. I don't like the hood at all. I mean, the hood in the old games looked brilliant, the way it was, like, massive, like, sort of rectangular things, you know. Green for when you have health, and red for when you're about to die. And then, of course, in the MK9, you've got the special move meter down the bottom and all. It looked cool, you know. But in this one, no. It looked like it was taking stuff from Injustice. So I hope it's not the final hood, you know. I don't really like the hood itself. So yeah, that's my small little rant on the font. My speculation there, story now, Ed Boon said that this was going to be from, you know, it's going to be after the events of MK9, and then it's going to kind of jump ahead in the future, so it'll be like 5 years after, 10 years after, 25 years after, and once it hits 25 years, I think it stays there. I'm sure we will see, either we'll hear mentions or we'll see cameos or something from the old MK Warriors. I do believe he's going to have a lot of them who are still alive in the story mode, or even maybe even flashbacks of, hey, do you remember that time when, who's dead? Who's dead? I can't remember who's dead. I don't know, let's, remember that time when, well, I know Sindel's dead. Yeah, remember that time when Sindel did this and killed all those lads? You know, you might see that in a flashback or something during the story. I'm not sure what the story's going to entail, though. I mean, how they're going to go about it, but it'd be interesting to see, really, you know. If I was to speculate on what sort of characters I think are going to be in Mortal Kombat, he said a Mortal Kombat 4 character is going to return. Now, I've seen, someone pointed out that I've seen an actor on IMBD, I think it's IMBD, say that she worked on Mortal Kombat, it just says Mortal Kombat, and it says 2014, and apparently it said Tanya, and it said villain, I think Tanya, villain, so it looks that way that Tanya is going to come back in some variation. I honestly can't remember where I had the link to this. If I find the link when I'm finding this video, I'll throw it up here, but I honestly can't remember where I seen it. If I was to pick, obviously, another MK4 character, you know Shinnok's going to be in it, cause in some way, because he was at the end of MK9, so he's in here somewhere, you know. If I was to pick someone else who would probably going to be in it, I'd imagine Raiden would be, or some sort of form of god, because, well, I know Kyle Khan's in there, but Raiden kind of has to be in it, because again, he's a protector of Earthrealm, and all this stuff's going to go down, and, you know, stuff like that. But if it was an older Raiden now, it'd look pretty cool, because, you know, it is in the future, but he doesn't age, I don't think, so it's not going to be too bad. If I was going to discuss what sort of modes I think are coming back, well, you've got the classic, you know, one-on-one. Tag wasn't apparently a popular mode in MK9, so they might not come back with that. I do hope they bring back the 8-player tournament from MK4. I like that sort of tournament mode, that was pretty cool. But I just kind of wish that at the end, when you finish them, or when you kill them, you can finish them, like, fatality-wise and stuff like that. That'd be pretty interesting. So, yeah, just all around, everything that's new that Ed Boon's bringing to the table, I like. It's just that the only problems I have, really, would be the font, the Outworld market, and the hood. Just that sort of a look. I honestly think they should change altogether. Online now, they've been saying that apparently they're going to have as much characters as MK9 had, so you're talking about 30, maybe more characters. Of course, they're bringing DLC back into it as well, and he said there would probably be a guest character, so it'd be interesting to see now who the guest character would be. I remember someone showed me a link to these pictures of Blade from the Blade series, Predator, and Ash Williams from Evil Dead. They'd all be interesting choices now. DLC online now has to be fluid. They're saying they're doing something with the online series that, like, even when you're playing single player, you're online and anybody can challenge you at any sort of given moment, I think, as long as you're not going through the story, which is going to be very interesting. And you're kind of, they're going to have to work out a lot of the slowness and stuff that was in MK9 online, because a lot of them, like, I mean, the matches and all were good, but they were very laggy. If they take a hint from Killer Instinct now, Killer Instinct is very fluid when I'm online. I don't have any sort of issues or bugs or anything with it, and people actually play properly online in Killer Instinct. There's no just doing the one move over and over again. I haven't faced anyone doing that. Yeah. Now, needless to say, I've only played 8 times with online people, but even still, like, even if you were playing Street Fighter or something, you'd only have to go into the third match or something, and someone will be Ryu, and they'll just keep Hadouken you and stuff like that. So hopefully with these variations and stuff, that will eliminate the whole one move wonder thing as well, you know. So just to recap, people, I like the look of the new MK, except for obviously the hood world and the font. Hopefully now, I can't wait to see the rest of the characters to come out. I can't wait to see the rest of the arenas. I'm looking forward to the new Alady. They said there's instead of a Fatality, there's a new Alady. It'll be really interesting to see. I hope it's Adam Alady. So this has been Pain Gaming, ladies and gentlemen, to give you my very quick, very not detailed, but there you go, yeah, recap on E3 and Mortal Kombat X. So join us, keep an eye here on Pain Gaming. We're going to be going through a lot of the MK coverage anytime trailers and stuff comes out. I'm going to lash it up on my channel. And I know a lot of you have been asking when I'm going to go back up to the Mortal Kombat 9 story mode and ladder, fast ladders. I'm going to be doing that soon enough anyway. I just wanted to get finish E3 and of course get this video done and edited anyway. So ladies and gentlemen, thanks for stopping by. Subscribe if you haven't. We're going to be talking about MK for the next year until it comes out. And hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in my next video. Goodbye. I'm